Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks very much for coming. We only have an hour, so I'm going to make the introductions very brief. My name's Justin McCurry from The Guardian. I'm also a member of the Professional Activities Committee here at the FCCJ. I'm sure you're all aware that this year, the 70th anniversary of the end of the Pacific War, that the Chiran Peace Museum in the town of Chiran, a major kamikaze base during the Second World War in Kagoshima Prefecture, is, I think, next month going to apply to have its collection of kamikaze-related documents, including letters, last letters from kamikaze pilots, letters from people who got to know them during their last days, and other documents included on the UNESCO World Memory List. Now, this is not gone without controversy. There are some who say that this is an attempt to incorrectly glorify the role of the kamikaze during the Second World War. The museum itself says that its collection is a valuable part of our collective wartime legacy, our wartime memory, and that it simply wants to remind people of the horrors of war. Now, fortunately, we have three speakers who know more about this UNESCO project than anyone. Delighted to have them here today. On my immediate right is Katsuro Ueno. Now, he's not going to speak, but he's here in his capacity as the new curator of the Chiran Peace Museum. Next to him is Kanpei Shimoide. He's the mayor of Minami Kyushu City in Kagoshima Prefecture. And next to the mayor is Mutsuo Kuwashiro, who is co-curator of the Chiran Peace Museum. And at the very end is Professor M.G. Scheftel, professor at Shizuoka University, who is acting as historical advisor to the UNESCO project. And our three speakers are going to make short statements, lasting about 10 minutes each. That should give us about half an hour for questions and answers. So who's actually going to speak first?
Have you decided? I'm going to go first.
Okay. So I hope you've all got your simultaneous translation gear at the ready, and we'll begin with remarks from Mayor Shimoide.
皆さんこんにちは。座ってお話をさせていただきたいと思います。本日はこのような機会をいただきまして誠にありがとうございます。心から御礼を申し上げたいと思います。70年前、世界の至るところで戦争が行われておりました。その様相は国民、経済や科学技術、政治、メディアなど 国家のすべてが動員された総力戦でございました。日本でも少年や学生などが兵士となり、女性や子供も後方から支援する役割を担いました。現在の南九州市は美しい茶畑の風景が広がるのどかな町でございます。しかし70年前は 日本陸軍の特攻基地が存在し、多くの特攻隊員の出撃を見送った町でございます。私たちはこの特攻隊員が亡くなる直前に書いた手紙や遺書などの資料を長期にわたり収集してまいりました。そして今回、これらの資料をユネスコ世界記憶遺産登録に向けて 申請を行うことといたしたところでございます。私たちの目的は特攻を賛美美化することや正当化することではございません。悲惨な戦争の記憶を後世に伝え、二度と戦争を繰り返さないために申請するものでございます。残念ながら日本が戦争を行い、 国内外の多くの人々に深い悲しみを与えた事実を変えることはできません。私たちはこの事実を踏まえ、同じ過ちを繰り返さないために 取り組んでいるのでございます。終戦から70年が経過し、戦争を知る当事者たちも多くは高齢になりました。しかしこの記憶を風化させるわけにはいきません。戦争は悲惨で残虐で愚かでございます。私たちは人類が二度と戦争を繰り返すことのないことを心から願っております。今回のこの活動が世界恒久平和の実現に向けた大きな一歩となると確信をいたしておるところでございます。私たちの活動にご理解とご支援のほどよろしくお願いを申し上げまして、ご挨拶に返させていただきたいと思います。本日はどうかよろしくお願いいたします。
桑代さん、どうぞ。
はい、皆さんこんにちは。私は鹿児島県南九州市世界記憶遺産に勤務しております、桑代睦男と申します。本日は南九州市が取り組んでおりますユネスコ世界記憶遺産登録申請物件について説明をいたします。よろしくお願いいたします。座って説明をさせていただきます。南九州市は2012年から所有している特攻関係資料を2017年ユネスコ世界記憶遺産に登録できるよう申請の準備を行っております。今回の申請の締め切りは6月19日です。申請の目的ですが、申請する物件は第二次世界大戦末期の人類が経験した歴史の証拠資料と考えています。戦後70年が経過し、戦争を経験していない世代が増えました。第二次世界大戦の記憶の風化が進む中、次世代がこのような戦争の恐怖を二度と経験しないよう、人類が経験したこの記録資料を保存します。特攻という軍の戦法概念を正当化するための申請では決してありません。特攻を賛美し美化するための申請では決してありません。申請物件の概要ですが、特攻隊員などが書き残した資料群は、近代に起こった総力戦の恐ろしさを伝える重要かつ稀有な遺言です。そのため、私たちは世界で共有すべき資料群であると信じています。また、戦争の恐ろしさ、悲惨さを伝える記録資料を通して、人類に平和の大切さ、二度と戦争を繰り返してはならないということを思い起こさせ、世界恒久平和に寄与することが私たちの願いです。今回の申請書のコンセプトですが、世界記憶遺産に申請する資料は、特攻隊員だけでなく、地域住民や学生など、国家全体が動員された総力戦の恐ろしさを伝える悲惨な歴史の証拠資料を申請すると決めました。本資料群は国家全体が総力戦に動員された時代の地域共同社会の様相を描写しています。資料は沖縄戦に参戦するため基地で特攻出撃を待つ特攻隊員直筆の資料と、その特攻基地近くにいた地域住民や特攻隊員と直接的間接的に交流を深めた学生らによる記録資料からなります。これらの記録は国家全体が巻き込まれた総力戦の恐ろしさと悲惨さを伝える悲惨な歴史の証拠資料であるということで、このコンセプトにいたしました。 すいません、ずれておりました。新生物件のタイトルは一覧に残された戦争の記憶と決めました。一覧は戦時中特攻を見送った地です。資料は一時期日本各地に所在する遺族や本人が保管していました。一覧は戦後どの地域よりもいち早く遺品の収集を始めました。そのため現在一覧は世界で最も多くの特攻関係資料を所有し、記録を継承する場所としても世界で認知されています。またサブタイトルは1945年沖縄戦に関する特攻関係資料群と決定しました。陸軍沖縄戦での特攻作戦は1945年3月から7月の約4ヶ月間という限られた中で行われました。資料群は沖縄戦における特攻作戦に出撃していった特攻隊員の資料と、特攻隊員と交流のあった女性や子どもらによる資料や記録も含まれます。総力戦で追い詰められた時の人間の純粋な証拠資料として残っているのがこの特攻関係資料群です。申請者は鹿児島県南九州市長下出寛平、申請の担当部署は南九州市世界記憶遺産推進室、資料の保管管理場所は一覧特攻平和会館です。本件の世界的重要性ですけれども、近代に発生した大規模な総力戦の歴史的背景を知る上で大変重要な社会的かつ歴史的現象に関する記録資料です。総力戦の状況下で人類が至った究極の行為を思い起こさせる貴重な資料として世界的重要性があります。人類や文化史においてコミュニティが経験した稀有な記録資料です。戦争の恐ろしさ悲惨さを全人類に思い起こさせるものとして役に立つ大変貴重な歴史的資料です。それでは申請する資料群の記録形態について説明いたします。資料の多くは紙や布に鉛筆や墨、ペンで書かれています。物資が不足した当時は便箋はもとより間に合わせの用紙に走り書きのように書かれたものもあります。これはタバコの黄色の包装紙を使用したものです。これはノートに書かれております。資料の書かれている様式も多様で、家族宛に書かれた遺書や手紙は自由な形式を用いてありのままの感情が綴られています。これは我が子に早く読めるように当時の学校教育において最初に読み書きを学習する文字、カタカナで書かれています。特徴的なものに自らの血液を用いた血書もあります。遺書や手紙の宛先も多様です。一番多い宛先は母親宛です。子供に宛てた手紙や婚約をしていた恋人へ宛てた手紙もあります。この寄せ書きの鉢巻きはアメリカ海軍兵であった人物が14年にわたり保管した後、1959年に遺族に返還されたものです。女子学生が特攻隊員との交流を綴った日記や特攻隊員に送ったマスコット人形です。さらに当時の小学生が特攻隊員の遺族へ書いた手紙もあります。これら資料は女子学生、子どもまでもが動員された総力戦の様相が伝わってくる資料でもあります。一覧は1941年に一覧飛行場が開設され、陸軍パイロット養成の中心地でした。 しかし第二次世界大戦末期、戦況の悪化で1945年には沖縄への日本本土最南端の特攻基地へと変化しました。知覧の歴史は日本が危機的状況に追い込まれ国家総力戦の様相となったことに巻き込まれる形で変化を遂げています。知覧は特攻基地が存在した歴史的経緯から終戦わずか5年後頃から特攻に関する資料収集を開始し現在に至っている地域の特異性があります。知覧特攻平和会館には世界各国から年間約55万人うち外国人も約1万人が訪れており、平和を学ぶ地、平和への祈りの場として現在でも多大な影響を与えています。さらに小学校、中学校、高等学校の平和学習の一環として全国から年間620校もの学校が戦争の恐ろしさと平和について学ぶために知覧を訪れています。最後になりましたが、この写真は1945年4月12日特攻機を見送る当時14、5歳の知覧高等女学校の学生たちです。この写真こそ総力戦の悲惨さが如実に表されています。この写真には写っていませんが、その傍らで当時15歳の私の母も含まれています。まだ健在で私と同居しております。母の口癖は、あんなむごいことは二度と経験したくない、あんなつらい思いはもうごめんだという言葉です。数少ない生き証人です。戦後70年が経過し世代が変わり戦争の風化が懸念されます。当時の町民の記憶、飛び立った若者たちの記憶、これを南九州市民全体で後世へ語り継ぎ、この悲惨な歴史的証拠資料を永久保存し、二度と悲惨な戦争が起こらないことの願いを持ち続けながら、2017年のユネスコ世界記憶遺産登録を目指します。以上で南九州市の世界記憶遺産申請に関する資料の説明を終わります。ご清聴ありがとうございました。Thank you.
Thank you very much. Professor Schefter.
I'm just going to start from the sitting position. I don't have to apologize for that, do I? Okay. Also a note on terminology for our non-Japanese speaking colleagues. I'm going to use the standard the world standard to describe Toko is which is kamikaze. I don't really like to use that word normally, and I don't use it in my academic writing, but I'm going to use it here for the purposes of this press conference. So now I can go straight to my my cunning paper here. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I'd like to say that it is truly an honor to be up here in front of the famous blue and gold tapestry of the FCCJ, something I've dreamed about doing since coming here in the Showa period, long, long ago, and in the fine company of my Chiran colleagues, and in the capacity of being able to lend my support to such a worthy cause. Before I begin the main part of my talk, I'd like to briefly explain why and how I'm up here today in the first place and at all. In the summer of 2012, I received a phone call inviting me to assist the Chiran UNESCO project for one of the girls in that picture. Let's call her Miss M. She was a former member of the Nadeshiko Schoolgirl Volunteer Unit that, during the Battle of Okinawa, did volunteer work for the kamikaze pilots at Chiran base. We had come to know each other 10 years earlier in the spring of 2002, when I was researching a book on kamikaze survivors, and we'd become fairly close since then. I must admit that coming from anyone else, I would have been pretty suspicious of ulterior political motives behind such an invitation, and probably would not have accepted it. But as it turned out, I had no reason to be suspicious of anything. I believe the Chiran Peace Museum's collection of kamikaze-related documents deserves to be in the UNESCO Memory of the World Registry, and that this application and the efforts behind it are in themselves significant and newsworthy. I also want to make it clear right from the start that this application process, again, is not being undertaken with the aim of glorifying or sentimentalizing the kamikaze legacy in any way or to rationalize the use of kamikaze tactics during the war. Minami Kyushu City's UNESCO application is entirely the work of our project team, of which I'm proud to be a member, and we accept full and sole responsibility for its content and consequences. No outside political pressure or government agency has in any way tried to influence or interfere with our work. Over the past 3 years, we've worked hard to negotiate a historical narrative of Japan's kamikaze campaign during the Battle of Okinawa from the perspectives of both Japanese military and civilian experience that we hope will be acceptable to the maximum possible number of people, both in and outside of Japan. We've done this while remaining respectful of the memory of the dead on both sides and of the sensitivities of the war's survivors also on both sides, without in any way sacrificing historical candor or sugarcoating anything in sentimentality. This has not been an easy process. We've had our fights and screaming arguments. But since Shiran first approached me in the summer of 2012 to assist in their project, we've talked through our differences, we've found common ground, and along the way we've achieved mutual trust, respect, and friendship. I believe that what our team has achieved can be, in microcosm, a model for how different cultures with a shared tragic history can overcome their differences of perspective and political views and their lingering resentments to negotiate an explanation of history that is acceptable to all involved, that can achieve reconciliation without rancor and do so without resorting to attempts to whitewash or airbrush the past or point fingers of blame. This spring, our team helped organize a joint exhibit about kamikaze at the USS Missouri Memorial Museum in Pearl Harbor, aboard an American warship that was itself hit by a kamikaze attack in April 1945 during the Battle of Okinawa. This is the first exhibit on modern Japanese military subject matter ever held outside of Japan with the cooperation of any Japanese institution, either public or private, obviously public in this case. In this exhibit, the Chiran and Missouri teams are not only narrating history, we're also making it. Initially, there were people on both the Chiran and the Missouri Museum sides who were very worried about possible political fallout about the idea for the exhibit. Even those of us who came up with the idea in the first place worried throughout the whole month-long process that news about the project would leak and that resulting protest or some form of official governmental pressure or diplomatic pressure would force us to cancel the exhibit. All of us are old enough to remember the Smithsonian debacle of 1995 with Enola Gay, and we did not want to repeat that, I think, tragic mistake. But when the exhibit actually opened last month at Pearl Harbor, it was to overwhelmingly favorable coverage in both American and Japanese news media. In the month since the exhibit opened, neither cooperating museum has reported receiving any negative feedback from the visiting public whatsoever. As things turned out, our fears about negative reactions were exaggerated, both in terms of lingering resentment among the American public over the kamikaze and over the war in general, and resentment among the Japanese public over the sharing of these sensitive war memories with outsiders, particularly a former enemy country. The main impression I think we've gotten from this experience is that the world is ready to learn more about the kamikaze, and the Chiran Peace Museum is exactly the right institution at the right time and with the most comprehensive resources at hand to make that possible. As we've worked on this project, especially over the past year, we've been aware that we are opening completely new territory in the realm of war memory discourse, not only in Japan, but internationally. Now, some people will have a problem with that. Okay, I get it, that's inevitable. But we have faith that most people will appreciate the worth of our efforts and the contributions we hope we can make to world peace. And we hope that many more war memory projects like ours and the symbolic gestures of reconciliation between former enemies that they entail will be soon to follow, not only in Japan, but also in America and other countries as well. Now, I'd like to talk to you about the concept of modern industrialized total war for you, and to explain its central role in the framework of our application. In our usage, the term refers to a condition in which, a condition of war, obviously, in which nation states with large populations, world-class economies and industrial might, and huge arsenals of advanced weaponry engage in warfare with similarly equipped nation states, mobilizing the full weight of their combined resources, their gross national power, if you will, with the aim of completely obliterating their opponent nation state, either as a political entity or in actual genocidal terms, as it could be argued we saw on the Eastern Front of the Second World War. But total war is not just a term describing megadeth body counts and the full mobilization of nation states' resources for war. Total war is also a state of mind. And just as the normal laws of physics become warped and distorted inside of a black hole, the normal laws of human nature become warped and distorted under total war conditions. Not only the ranks of the military, but entire civilian populations of tens of millions of people, including women and children, are psychologically primed and mobilized for the war by education systems and mass communications. And the resultant destruction and suffering, as history shows us, in terms of scale and degree, denies belief. And this is true for all sides involved in such a conflict to that degree and at that scale, both the defeated and the victors. And if you don't believe that, just ask anyone who spent the Second World War in Russia or China who is old enough to remember the experience. Everyone is ultimately a victim in total war. Nobody walks away with it without scars and without grief. By our definition, humanity's last such conflict ended in 1945. And it is our fervent hope that that should remain humanity's last such conflict. This is the solemn lesson taught to us not only by the kamikaze legacy, but by the legacies of all of the horrific events of that war, seared forever into human collective memory. Bombed cities engulfed by firestorms, this one included. Captured cities raped and massacred by rampaging soldiers. Internment camps where people interned their own citizens. Death camps, genocide, gulags, slave labor, atomic bombings, madness, horrors, atrocities, all. We regard that era, and I regard that era, as a collective failure on the part of the human race, as a period of temporary madness that gripped our entire species, or at least those of us who were in the primary war-making industrial powers at the time. It was an era when the pace of advances in the development of lethal weapons technology outstripped the ability of our collective sanity and common sense to keep up with this so-called progress, with the whole catastrophic system almost taking on a mind of its own, fueled by national propaganda machines of superb efficiency that stoked our mutual hatred, trapped all of us in our own patriotic rhetoric, and caused us to both inflict and suffer unimaginable levels of bloodshed. The Chiran documents comprise an invaluable time capsule from a world that humanity cannot and must not ever inhabit again, and certainly not while we share the planet with 16,000 thermonuclear warheads. In some hopefully not too far off future, in which all wars, not just total wars, have disappeared from living memory, archives such as Chiran's will continue to remind future generations of the preciousness of peace and serve as a warning never to return to our ancestors' obsession with and misplaced admiration for the fighting of wars. In closing, I would like to ask you, to beseech you, to resist the temptation to leave this room today and go file an easy to write and easy to read, but also completely false story that will go something like, oh no, There go the Japanese again, trying to glorify the kamikaze, and now somehow they've corralled some American hipster doofus from the provinces into helping them. Now, while the hipster doofus from the provinces part might be right, none of the rest of that story is true. I haven't been corralled or bamboozled into anything, and no one is trying to glorify the kamikaze here. I'm involved in this project because I believe the Chiran documents can make a contribution to world peace. That's why I now ask you, the members of the world press, Japanese and non-Japanese alike, to understand it and to use your awesome powers of influence to support us. This may not be easy for you. Some of your readers and some of your viewers will be upset by this project. I ask you to explain to them what you've heard and seen today. People generally don't like their worldviews tampered with. And our project and the approach our project is taking is going to challenge some people's worldviews in Japan and outside of Japan. I understand that. But I ask you to give us a fair shake. Please don't slant the story. In return, I can assure you, and I stake my professional reputation on this promise, that the Chiran Project is not being undertaken to glorify a dark era of humanity's past, but rather by shining a light on that era, by holding up a mirror to our not-so-distant past, a past to which we must never return. This project is being undertaken to make a contribution to lasting peace in humanity's future. The world needs the Chiran documents so that nothing like kamikaze will ever happen again. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now we'll go to questions. I'm going to ask members of the working press to ask questions first. If you would just state your name, name of your organization, and keep your questions to one at a time, please. And I didn't remind people earlier, but please do switch your mobile phones to manner mode. Richard, I saw your hand up first.
Thank you. Richard Lloyd Parry of The Times. A question for the mayor and Mr. Kuashiro, I think. It's been a few years since I visited your fascinating museum. But when I did last go there, the impression I received was very different from the impression you have given us today. As far as I can remember, the museum doesn't contain the word horror anywhere, and certainly doesn't talk about industrialized total war, which is the theme you've been emphasizing today. The impression I got was that the kamikaze program is viewed in the museum certainly as a tragedy, but also as a, in some ways, a noble sacrifice, almost as a beautiful sacrifice. And I wonder if you could explain rather that discrepancy between the message you're giving us today and the message transmitted by the museum. Thank you.
それでは私の方からお答えをさせていただきたいと思います。今ご質問にありましたように美化されているというふうにお感じになったということでございますが、これは私どもの努力不足だろうというふうに反省もいたします。現在もですね、この戦争の悲惨さ、そして命の大切さ、そういうものをですね前面に出して、いろいろとアドバイザーも説明をいたしておるところでございます。そういうことで、全国からですね、小学生、中学生、高校生、平和学習ということで多くの皆さんがですね知覧を訪れて、そして遺書を読んでいただいてですね、こんな悲惨な戦争は二度と起こしてはならないというふうに感じて、帰っていただいておるところでございます。これからもですね、そのような誤解を招かないようにしっかりと私ども取り組んでいきたいと、このように思っております。
補足しました。チラン特攻平和会館はですね、特攻隊員の残した資料、遺書、手紙等を通して、史実を通してですね、当時の遺品や関係資料を 次世代へ保存継承するとともに二度と悲惨な戦争を起こしてはならないという平和へのメッセージを発信しております。さらに戦争の悲惨さ、平和の大切さ、命の尊さを語り継ぎ、世界恒久の平和を祈念するのが知覧特攻平和会館の理念でございます。
Okay, next question.
Siegfried Nidl, freelancer from Germany. I think I visited the museum also perhaps 10 years ago. What I think now about when you said every time it should set, this kind of war should never be happen. I think in this way it's necessary to say who was responsible for the war. So it's no message in the museum about who was responsible. I think a kind of talking about not to make this kind of war again, it means to learn why this war happened, who was responsible, and then this way how to avoid a war in a similar way.
Did you have a question? Please go back to the microphone. Thanks.
So in this way, I would like to ask you, do you think about talking about who was responsible for war? To talk about it.
Do any of you want to take on that question or something?
Okay. はい。南九州市はですね、遺族から寄贈された資料を保存している地方自治体でございます。そのため戦争責任について、答える立場に今ちょっとないところでございます。
I'd like to add a comment to that. I've actually been researching the history of Chiran for almost as long as I have the Toko phenomenon itself. And I think it would help to know a bit of the historical background of that facility. It started off as a war memorial, not as a museum. So in a way, you could say that the course that the evolution of that institution would take was set by its initial identity as a memorial. It was a place where people would go, they would give flowers, they would pray for the dead, and it sort of evolved from that and grew. So in an ideal world, we would be tackling those problems immediately, and I'm ready at any time when everyone else is on board with that. But there are 60 years of traditions and standard operation procedures and tears soaked into that soil that we can't. It's going to take time to work on that. And one of the things that I'm personally looking forward to hoping will happen is that this project will give a sort of push from behind to make this a museum that's more in line with, more appropriate for 21st century and for visitors from all over the world. So I agree with you, sir, that's very important to go into that.
Thank you. Next question. Stefano.
I'm Stefano Carrer for the Italian Economic Daily, Sole 24 Ore. One problem of this application is maybe the timing. So there is an ongoing controversy about the fact that the Japanese central government is pushing hard this issue of 23 industrial sites as a symbol of Japan modernization. And some of these sites are controversial. So the very fact that there is an ongoing controversy, don't you think that it could damaging this application? Thanks.
Well, I think your question illustrates a point I was making in here about how we are not coordinating our efforts with anybody here in Tokyo or anywhere else other than the City Hall of Minami Kyushu. Another thing I'd like everyone to recall, to remember, is you'll recall in my talk, I said that I was approached in the summer of 2012. Now, everyone here should remember when the Abe Part II was elected to office. It was December, okay? So this was all being talked about, not only with me 6 months earlier, but years earlier, years before the return of the Abe regime to power. So this has nothing to do at all with the central government. And in fact, I sometimes wonder if what they really think of this application, if they'd maybe just wish that we would go away. Yeah, the timing with the 23 sites in Kyushu is unfortunate, but there's really nothing we can do about it. And Chiran, obviously, is, you know, it's a little tea farming town. It's not a Meiji industrial heritage site. So I want to say it has nothing to do with this, but, you know, unfortunate public opinion and international public opinion doesn't work that way. So, you know, well, all we can do is hope that the strength of our argument will win over.
Patrick Zollnoy, Zürcher Zeitung from Switzerland. We just had a case in Osaka where the Peace Museum had to rewrite, to a certain extent, its history under pressure from the Hashimoto government. What gives you assurances that your museum will be kept in the spirit you want to have it in the coming years, decades, without politicians with a very, very different view taking it over and forming it in a way they want to see it, a more revisionist view?
Well, I plan to be around for a while. I'll go down there and straighten some folks out if that needs to be doing.
Anybody else? はい。はい。そういう懸念もあろうかと思いますが、もうこれはですね、我々のこういう平和会館としての方針でやっておることでございますので、そういったことはですね、いろんな方々からそういう圧力があってもですね、断固としてこれは我々は今ルルお話をしましたような趣旨に基づいてこれからも頑張っていきたいとこのように思っております。
I am very confused. My name is Khalil Hassan. I'm ambassador of Bahrain. At the same time, I've been a medical doctor. And my job is to protect life. Not only the others, we have to protect our own life. Now, we know that what happened in New York, Bin Laden sent this suicidal group, and they did what they did. They didn't destroy the United States, they destroyed the Middle East. And now we have ISIS. And these people are trying to promote things like this and trying to get all the youth around the world to come and work with them. Now, this is my question. In this environment, okay, and you are saying we don't want to glorify this issue, but how can you prevent? I agree with you that we have to record history properly, but how can you prevent glorifying this without you are realizing it? Thank you, sir.
いいですか。はい。私どもです。ぜひこの知覧に来て衣装を見ていただきたいと。こういう大変強い願望を持っております。そうでないとですね、我々がいくら皆様方にこうしてご説明をいたしましてもですね、真実は伝わらないだろうというふうに思っているところです。やはり若くして生きられなかった者たちのですね、生のこの気持ちというものをですね、 治安の特攻平和会館に来て直に触れていただければ私はそういった我々の気持ちというものは十分世界の皆さん方にですね理解してもらえるのではないかなとこのように確信をいたしておるところです。本当に我々も美化にならないようにこの特攻の賛美にならないようにというですねもうこれは常に頭の中に入れながらですね活動を続けておるところでございます。まあ、今後においてもですね、まあ、そういった、懸念が少しでも皆さん方のにありましたらですね率直に言っていただければ私どもも素直にですねこれは改善をしていきたいとこのように思っておりますのでどうかよろしくお願いいたしたいと思います。
If I can add a comment here. History always has a susceptibility to being abused by demagogues and people who would twist it to getting other people to follow their plans of destruction. Now, I would ask you, sir, would it be better to leave this history, which is not going to go away, it'll always be remembered by humanity, would it be better to leave the teaching of this history to young people and future generations, to comic book artists or to movie studios? I think it's better that at least there be some voice in the wilderness, a voice of reason that is responsible in its telling of history and its preserving of that record. Otherwise, you leave it to the crackpots, and I see a far greater danger in that than in us trying to record for posterity and future generations the experiences that human beings had in southern Kyushu in 1945. Thank you.
Kaori Hitomi from Associated Press. I think all of you are aware of the danger or risks of this to be given more profile and the possibility of some people using your institution for their own purposes at the time. So you are all aware of that. So I'm wondering, I think everybody is asking the same question, asking why this needs to go into sort of UNESCO World Heritage category. There are many ways in this world nowadays. There's YouTube, you can tweet and things like that. So there are many ways to across your voice and across your message. And I think by giving more profile in this way, UNESCO World Heritage, there could be more of increasing risks of you being used. How, and I don't quite hear from you, how you can confirm not to make it happen.
Well, this relates sort of to what I was saying to Mr. Ambassador before. We can't control what other people will do with this. And yes, if our project is successful, it's going to raise the profile of the toko. But the only thing we can do on our side and what we will bend over backwards trying to do will be to make sure that this narrative, the one that we've been very patiently and sometimes angrily hammering out between ourselves over the 3 years is the one that goes on the letterhead, if you will, on the Kanban of the museum, that this is not a glorification. And anyone who comes to the museum and sees it or who encounters this material on the UNESCO website or something, or wherever, should be sobered and saddened and depressed by this story. They should see this and think, what if my children get in that situation someday, right? What can I do to make sure that never happens? That's what we want to be done with this material. We can't stop some crazy person from trying to make a glorious myth or something out of our material. It's not in our control, but we can do what we can to get this message out, and you can help us do that. Please do.
And may I also hear voices from mayors and museum people as well?
あの私どもがですねユネスコに登録しようということはですね、もうこれあの世界的にですね権威のあるユネスコでございますので、これに登録ができたらですね多くの方々が関心を持って来ていただけるんじゃないかということです。来ていただけたら我々のこのそういう真意というものがですね十分理解をしていただけるというようなことでですね、まず我々は来て読んでいただきたい、そういう願いを持って今こういう活動を続けております。
Can I add one more comment? To the best of my knowledge, in this Memory of the World program, which I hope everyone is on board with the fact that the Memory of the World is not like some sort of a cultural award and saying that this is something beautiful that the community should remember forever. There are good memories, there are happy human memories in the Memory of the World program, and there are also very horrific and tragic memories in it as well. And to the best of my knowledge, there are at present two other Memory of the World successful projects which were included in the registry. And one of those was for the Battle of the Somme, which was probably the most iconic slaughter and maybe the most senseless war in human history, which resulted in some 30 million human casualties, I believe. And this was propaganda film that was made by the British government during World War I to be shown back on the home front to raise people's spirits and say, you know, you can feel good about your son being slaughtered because it's all, you know, for king and country. And the other war-related successfully Memory of the World application that comes to mind is for the Auschwitz documents from the camp, passenger manifest for the trains that brought people into the camp. And I don't mean to be insulting or anything, but following the logic here would be like, well, you know, if you put that up for the Memory of the World, and you put the Battle of the Somme stuff up for Memory of the World, well, maybe young people will get that and they'll suddenly want to charge into machine gun nests or set up death camps in their backyard. I mean, this is a tragic memory. It's not something glorious, and. Well, I have enough faith in the human race. I don't know if it's well-founded or not, but that people will see this, they'll think it through, and they'll look at this material and think that we don't want to see this world again, and that's the message that we've been repeating over and over again. I hope I've answered sort of your questions. Thank you.
Thank you. Can I confirm that the Battle of the Somme and the Auschwitz passenger manifest, that they are already part of the UNESCO World Memory List. Is that correct?
Yes.
Right, and they're not part of the applications
no,
this year?
No.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Next question from the working press, please.
My name is Hiro Kujita, a former editor-writer of the Kokubi Shimbun founded by Tokutomi Soho, 1890. Currently, I'm independent, writing for Sapio, Yukan Fuji, Super. I feel very sympathetic to Tokotai people because, for example, Tokyo bomb airborne raid, March 10th, in a couple of hours, over 100,000 people were killed. They were civilians. Soldiers were outside fighting American forces. So people in Tokyo at that time were mostly women, children and senior citizens. And also additionally, over 100 cities were bombed. It's a severe massacre, over 300,000 people. Observing that, I feel very sympathetic that Tokotai people resort to the death to save the people living in mainland Japan. What is your opinion, Professor?
All right, now when you speak about Tokotai people, do you mean the pilots or the people who are giving the orders?
Pilots.
So you're assuming that the pilots went into this as 100% volunteers and we want to go and Right.
Most of the people, they sacrifice their lives to save wife, children, family.
Yes.
I think we have an idea of the question.
Yeah.
Professor Schefdal, if you'd like to
answer
that point.
Yes, I've, Mr. Kishida, I've been studying this toko phenomenon for 15 years, and I would say that over those 15 years, there probably been at least 100 nights, maybe 200, where I was not able to sleep. Because when you do research like this, you try to put yourself in the position of the people who are doing those things. I've been living in Japan for 30 years. I know the language, I know the culture, I know the value systems. So perhaps I'm better qualified than most Westerners to study this topic. And actually, this is part of the reason why I started in the first place. I often try to imagine if some fleet from some other country or had been off of New York City. I'm from New York City, shelling the city, bombing with strategic bombing, burning up my family, etc. I would have been very motivated to do whatever possible to resist that. But do we want to see that world again?
No.
Yeah. Yeah, of course. Of course. Yeah. So that's our point. Okay. Are we okay with time? I'd like to talk to you afterwards, okay, and continue this conversation, okay?
Thank you. We've got time for one more question. Okay. If you're going to follow up in any way, please do stay at the microphone because it needs to be interpreted and recorded for YouTube. Thank you.
Kiyoshi Takenaka, Reuters. A brief question. What is your view on China's bid to get comfort women-related document and Nanjing massacre-related document in the list under the same program? This is a question for whoever is willing to answer. Thank you.
Okay, I'll answer that. If the documents are valid and they can be confirmed as actually historic, then I think they should be in the program, obviously. Yeah, as a historian, that's what I would say. This isn't about which country is wrong and right. It's about documentary evidence from unhappy times in human experience being preserved from whichever country it's from. It doesn't matter. If those documents are valid and can be validated as such, then certainly anything like that should be preserved. Okay. Mm. But this is only my opinion. Sure. I don't know if it's the same opinion as my colleagues.
よろしいですか。これは大きな問題でありまして、私どもこの地方のですね、一都市の首長が、言及することではないだろうというふうに思っております。お許しをいただきたいと思います。
Okay, we have time for one more quick question. I think it's 1 minute too.
すみません、AFP 通信社、小沢といいます。今日の会見で市長からも学芸員になられる方々からも特攻を美化するものではないと、賛美するものではないということを何度も繰り返し言葉でご説明されていますが、実際にその言葉だけでは本当に美化していないものなのか、賛美していないものなのか、なかなか難しいものがあるかと思います。具体的にこれは本当に美化するものではないんだというような具体的な行動であるとか、例えば名前の付け方であるとか、そういったことはされるご予定はありますか。
I think we're saying that for you. so that we won't be misunderstood. That's why we are repeating that. And we see that there'd be a danger of people misinterpreting what we're trying to do, and we're trying to convince you that that's not what we're doing.
Right, but it is very easy to glorify the past while saying that we are not glorifying the past. So I think it is very easy, it's very important to do something tangible, something concrete in action. So are you planning to do, to make any action, concrete actions? Thank you.
Okay. シェフタル教授の方からもお話がありましたようにですね、先般ミズーリ記念館と一緒になってですね、この私どものこの平和会館で収蔵しております資料をですね、展示をさせていただきました。そしてアメリカの方々にもそれを見ていただきました。これからもですね、いろいろなところでこの展示会というものを開催をいたしましてですね、一人でも多くの方々に、ね、見ていただいて、そして理解をしていただける、いただくような努力はしていかなければいけないだろうというふうに思っております。特に外国の方々とのですね、連携も取りながら、私どもの真の気持ちをですね、お伝えできればとこのように思っております。これからもいろんな方々のお知恵もいただきながらですね、最大の努力をしてまいりたいとこのように思っております。
Thank you very much. That's all we've got time for. If you could just remain in your seats for a few minutes. Three of our guests have flights to catch back to Kyushu, so that they can't hang around for too long.
I'll be around though.
My final duty for the afternoon is to first of all thank our guests very much for coming and for a very interesting talk, and also toas is customary, to give them a one-year honorary membership of the Foreign Correspondents Club. So if you have the opportunity over the next 12 months to visit us again, please do come along. In the meantime, please give our guests another round of applause. Thank you.